This address was given by Lindon Nairn on March 20th, 2011, on the occasion of the launch of his campaign in the Seabreeze constituency. At the time of the address, Lindon was deputy leader of the National Development Party. Lindon is a chartered accountant. His involvement in social development in the Bahamas has been extensive and includes working with at-risk boys who attend SC McPherson and underprivileged children from the inner-city communities. For more than 10 years, he served as a director, then chairman of the Training Center for the Disabled. In addition, for more than 10 years, he served as a consultant and director of Great Commission Ministries, a nonprofit organization that provides food, clothing, and shelter for people in need. Lindon has also led and sponsored national events designed to identify ways to improve the economy of the Bahamas.
Brothers and sisters of Seabreeze constituency, ladies and gentlemen, it is my esteemed privilege to be here today. The Lord Himself delivered the people of Israel from the cruel grips of the Egyptians. Yet, they spent 40 years in the wilderness, going round in circles. Every day, they picked up their tents and walked round and round the mountain, as it were, walking and getting tired, but going nowhere. Every day, they did the same thing, expecting a different result. But a different result was not to be. The questions for us are, when will our years of wandering in the political, social, and economic wilderness end? Shall we travel round and round the mountain, or shall we embrace change? For almost 20 years, the residents of Seabreeze complained about rusty water that was damaging their health, clothes, plumbing fixtures, appliances, and cars. It did not matter to whom they complained. The response was the same: a deafening silence. Now, contrary to what Honorable Carl Bethel said, changing the pipes on Robinson Road and Prince Charles alone will not solve the problem. The problem will not be resolved until the pipes through the side streets are removed. Today, I want Seabreeze to know that your nightmare will soon come to an end. Soon I will update you on specific steps that are being taken to bring you relief. Residents of Seabreeze, I want you to know that I will fight for you. I will fight with you. I will fight against those who fight against you. I'll make you proud. The eastern end of the island is known for heart-wrenching traffic. Every day, we watch helplessly as the productivity of thousands of Bahamians is partly spent in traffic. The PLP and the FNM have responded by building roads that lead to the same bottleneck. A major part of the real solution, however, is a 21st century public transportation system. That's what we will do shortly after coming to office. Residents of Seabreeze, we live in a country that turns a blind eye to those who are hurting in our society. One need not go far into Nassau Village to see the blatant and sinful neglect of our government. Well, I have good news for you today. Those days are coming to an end soon. Soon we will stop pretending that we do not have men who, though they have served their time in prison, are not given the time of day in society. Soon we will stop pretending that we do not have mothers who are unable to work and adequately take care of their children. Soon we will stop pretending that despite working hard for 40 hours each week, we do not have tens of thousands of workers who cannot make ends meet. Soon. Yes, my brothers and sisters, soon. Soon we will embark on a social program called Operations Restore, of a scale that has never before been seen in the Bahamas. We will triple the social budget. I'll fight for you. I will make you proud. Sadly, the Bahamian people have been the victims of administrations that lack the needed conviction, humanity, and integrity to address illegal immigration. As a consequence, illegal shantytowns are scattered throughout the Bahamas. One such shantytown is in the Seabreeze constituency. We in the National Development Party believe that such living conditions are unsatisfactory and encourage undesirable behaviors, not to mention the impact on the surrounding homes. A NDP government will remove all shantytowns. And while doing so, a NDP government will be aware of the fact that many residents of shantytowns are Bahamians or are here legally. 1 month ago, I knocked on the door of a rather modest house. I was greeted by a young lady. She was tired and could not hide her unhappiness. She unwillingly shared her many struggles. Husband unemployed. Several adult children without jobs. Mortgage behind. Etc. etc. I can tell you many other stories just like that young lady's. Indeed, those are the stories of ordinary Bahamians. These stories, however, differ vastly from persons who occupy our parliament. Their stories go something like this. No, you got 600,000 from that foreign investor. Here's another. No, you got millions in contracts funneled through companies you own. Well, we believe in economic empowerment, just not that kind. A NDP government will be deliberate in its pursuit of economic empowerment. A NDP government will cause the weight of equity and fairness to crush the endemic economic foundation that is harmful to all Bahamians but a few. Ladies and gentlemen, I am told that 1,500 properties sold to Bahamians are under threat of being taken over by a large developer. Indeed, instead, rather, of a comprehensive solution being brought to bear on this matter, many significant institutions seem to have abandoned the residents of Selinden Pinlin Estates. Moreover, they seem to have little to no regard for the implications of this legal and financial web on their sectors specifically and the wider society. Whether it is the central bank that has not acknowledged the severe jeopardy banks face because hundreds of millions of dollars of their loans are effectively not collateralized, to the Bar Association, which seems to have buried its head in the sand, to the government, who refuses to inject a sensible rationale into the discussion. This is a national crisis of a magnitude that we have probably never seen in the Bahamas. Yet, it is as if the entire country and its essential organs have collaborated against the hard working people of Sir Lindon Pinlan Estates. It is not right for poor people to be asked to pay for the mistakes of others, while those same others enjoy the fat of the land. Tell them that we live in a society, not Animal Farm. We live in a society where we ought to protect the rights of the innocent. The law is not greater than the men and the women who create the law. And the law must be such that it serves the interests of the people. It is not the people who serve the interests of the law. And where that fundamental truism does not appear to exist, then the law must be changed. Know this, Seabreeze. Soon you will see them come from both sides. Come round, fixing things and making promises. For almost 5 years, they have turned a blind eye and a deaf ear to your concerns. And now, with an election on the horizon, they want to play the same game of polytricks, insulting your intelligence, wanting you to be so grateful for them, finally attempting to do the job that you elected them to do 5 years ago. For almost 5 years, we have been put on the back burner, and now they want to come around and act as if all is well in Seabreeze. Was it all well when the residents of Sir Lindon Pinlan Estates had to swallow the bitter pill of such a travesty and a grave injustice as losing their homes? Was it all well when so many persons lost their jobs? Was it all well when the people lost their hard-earned possessions because of rusty water being pumped into their homes? Seabreeze, the reality is that they don't care to fix our problems because they don't really care about us. But know this, we will work together for the greater good that concerns us all. We will walk together, hand in hand. We will toil together. We will stand together, shoulder to shoulder. And we will fight side by side for what we want and for what we know that we deserve. Seabreeze, I ask you for your vote. If you permit me to represent you, I'll work hard for you. I'll represent you well, and I'll make you proud. Whether in government or in opposition, I will work to advance your interests. As I close, let me tell you something about CIDCO, the organization which presides over the affairs of our country and that seeks to perpetuate their hold. C is for Christie. I is for Ingram. D is for Davis. And CO is for company. And that spells CIDCO. Well, we've got one message for CIDCO today. And that message is this. CIDCO got to go. CIDCO got to go. Seabreeze, in a few months, you will be called upon to vote. You will be called upon to vote for change or to vote for CIDCO. You will be asked to vote for Attorney Bethel or Attorney Sean, who have different last names, but everything else is the same. Or you can send me to the halls of Parliament. I make you this promise. There would be no louder voice, no stronger advocate, no one more creative. I'll work hard for you, Seabreeze. I'll make you proud. Give me this chance, and I'll give you my fullest commitment. I want to be your servant. I want to work for you. To date, in the currently politically charged atmosphere, we see the waves of change already crashing to the shores, and with it, we see dissension in the government. And this is only the beginning. The eyes of mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, daughters and sons of this Bahamian soil are becoming wide open. And this wave of change, this wave of revolution will continue to rise throughout every city and every street corner of this country. And so to my constituents and to my fellow Bahamians, I encourage you to actively embrace this change and then let it begin to flow. Let it dip into Elizabeth, Montague, Fox Hill, and Yamacore in the east. Let it flow into Pinewood, South Beach, and Kennedy in the west. Let the wave move to the southern islands of Grand Bahama, Abaco, and Long Island. And let it cross the seas to Michael, Andros, and Exuma. Let it flow. We can do this. Oh, yes, we can.